Hey, today's piece of content is a video that is called You Have No Idea How Wrong You Are, which I'll link to below in the description. This one is really good, and I'll try and get through kind of some basic points of it. It's a pretty long video, so I'll try and make as quick points of it as I can. So basically, the premise of it is that he starts out talking about how people have been wrong more in history than they have been right in history. And he basically explains how, like, I mean, there's more ways to be wrong than there are to be right. If you think about it, the way I thought about it is, so if you've got a target and you've got where you're aiming for, so say you're shooting a bow and arrow and you're aiming for this bullseye right in the middle, right? And so this is right. This is where you want to aim, but there's only one place to be right, but there's here to be wrong. There's here to be wrong. There's here to be wrong. Here to be wrong. Everywhere that's not here is wrong. And so you only have one right opinion or one right thing, but everywhere else outside of that can be wrong. So just because of the pure massive ability to be wrong, people in history have been wrong more than they have been right, even very intelligent speakers, which we'll talk about in just a second. But I think something that we then can tend to do is say, okay, well, these people in history got it wrong, but that was those people in history. Like, that was back when they thought about things like the sun orbited around the earth. Like, how stupid can you get, right? We've got that all that stuff figured out. But I think this is a really, really prideful standpoint to have, is to say, oh, well, they didn't have it figured out then, but now we've got it all figured out, so we couldn't possibly be wrong about anything. Science, technology, all that stuff, it's gone past that, so that we're right about everything. But we're still proving things wrong every single day about things that we previously believed. Next thing I think we can do is say, okay, well, science and people in history might have been wrong, but like for myself personally, I know when I'm right and I know when I'm wrong. Like, I might pretend not to, but I actually know when I'm right and when I'm wrong. But there have been quite a few studies that have basically proved that wrong. So there's one, I won't go into all of them just because I don't know enough detail about all of them, but he mentions one that is the blindsight thing, where people have like the perception that they're blind, but in reality, if you put them in an obstacle course and then you set them free, then they can go around the obstacles. So something like, even though in their brain they perceive that they're blind, they're not. So they're like, their mind is playing tricks on them. So there's that. And then even just everyday people, there have been a lot of studies that have shown that people overestimate what they can do. I think of it even a lot of times you see older people who will try and go and do things that they really can't do, but they believe that they can do it. You know, they think they're still young and chipper and can do whatever, but in reality, they really can't. And that applies even to us as younger people. Whether you're athletic or not, you may think, oh yeah, I can do that, or I'm really good at that. But in reality, you may not actually be that good at that thing. So we just have these misperceptions of we think we're right when a lot of times we're wrong. So then after that, kind of comes to the realization, wow, so if I'm wrong about a lot of these things, then that's really bad, right? Like, if I'm wrong, then what am I going to do? But this really isn't, we have to ask ourselves, is it wrong? Is it bad? Is it a bad thing? And looking at a lot of these great thinkers from history, in this video, he talks about Aristotle and Isaac Newton and Einstein, and how obviously, like in their day, and even now, they're held as these incredible people who had discoveries and discovered things that were way ahead of their time. But they're wrong about a lot of things now, and so because of that, we can be tempted to say like, oh, like it was all waste, but it really wasn't. Like their discoveries led to next discoveries that led to the next discoveries, and the idea was, they weren't afraid to be wrong about things. So they went after things and they weren't afraid. Okay, I might be wrong about this, but it might lead to this other discovery. So you have to be willing to be wrong about some things in our lives. Even us, who we may not be, Einstein, we may not be Isaac Newton, but we have to be willing to be wrong about some things so that we can further develop ourselves and the world around us. There are a couple of quotes that, well, there's a quote that they had in it from Socrates, I believe, and it is, wisest is he who knows he knows nothing. And this reminded me of a Bible verse in 1 Corinthians where it says, if anyone imagines that he knows something, he does not yet know what he ought to know. So when we kind of step back and we believe, okay, I really don't know, I don't know all these things, then that's when we can really, I think, start to make progress and say, hey, I might not know this. I might be wrong. I might be wrong about this thing, but I'm gonna go after it. Like, I'm gonna pursue it as far as I can, and be content in knowing that you might You might not know everything. You might not even ever know fully yourself. You might not fully understand all those things, but that's kind of the joy in it. That's kind of what the speaker closes with, is he talks about how he's happy that he'll never fully understand. He'll never fully know himself. He uses every day to learn more about the things that are going on. And every day there are more, more things that he learns. So the one caveat that I do want to put in is I believe that there was one person who is always right in the world. Everyone else has always been wrong about certain things. But one person I believe was right was Jesus in the Bible. Obviously, I don't think that the speaker would agree with me, because I've seen some of his other videos and I definitely don't think he's a Christian. But I believe that Jesus was right on everything that he ever said. And also that God speaks to us through his word, which speaks truth to us. There's nothing in the Bible that's going to be wrong. And so for a lot of this philosophy kind of stuff of like, oh no, like you never know where you're going to be right, I think you can take it too far of like, oh, like you never fully know what's happening, so you got to constantly be searching here and people could be wrong all the time. We have a book of truth. We have a book of life that everything in it is truth. It's been inspired by the word of God who knows all things. And if we study that, then we can fully know the truth and about everything. But yeah, that's just the one caveat that I put in. A really, really fantastic video that this guy has. Yeah, definitely encourage you to check it out.